golden rule of social media is engagement and storytelling. So it's kind of giving customers stories that they can relate to, be it that you're a brand or that you're a person. You know, you at the end of the day, it's all about the storytelling.
Hello and welcome to Coffee and Conversation on BTCN. I'm your host, Shashank Bengali. I'm here with Alan Dobrea. He's the head of brand partnerships for Zalora, one of the biggest fashion e-commerce platforms in the region. Alan, thanks for joining us.
Hi, thanks for having me.
So tell us a bit about what you're hoping to achieve here at the conference.
So I'm here just to connect with different tech providers, as well as fashion brands and also non-fashion partners, just to understand how they're looking at e-commerce and marketing in the region.
You're working at, as I said, one of the biggest fashion platforms in all of Southeast Asia. What has it been like for you to tap into these big and emerging markets with the e-commerce strategy that Zalora has?
It's been a very exciting journey. So I think we're seeing amazing growth across the region in all of the markets in Asia, especially in Southeast Asia. We can see a huge boom. We've seen it in China, right, a couple of years back, and now it's spreading across markets like Indonesia, Philippines. They have a huge middle class that's booming, and we're seeing very, very good growth in these markets.
And you came from Marks & Spencer. You used to work in London for Marks & Spencer, a venerable bricks and mortar retail business, and now you're working for a digital business. What has that evolution been like for you to see the changes in marketing from one to the other?
So I think moving from a bricks and mortar like focused business to a pure play digital business has been super exciting. Even in Marks & Spencer, we had an online business, which was still quite big. In some departments, it was already 30-40% of the sales.
Do you feel like in Southeast Asia, for example, you mentioned Indonesia, Philippines, some of these big markets that we have here, that customers, particularly in the second and third tier cities, are kind of leapfrogging into digital technologies, and are they more comfortable buying, for example, fashion online than perhaps consumers in other parts of the world that are used to traditional bricks and mortar companies?
Yeah, absolutely. So what I've seen, obviously moving from the UK and looking mainly at Europe, is that customers in these more evolved markets, they would mainly shop on desktop. Everything you do here has to start with mobile. So you have to think about every single interaction, making sure that the customer journey is spot on the mobile devices. Like you mentioned, customers in these markets have leapfrogged, so there was no desktop for a lot of them. They just went straight into a mobile first world.
And given the issues that some areas still have with connectivity and 4G access, how does Zalora ensure that the app is optimized for people all across the region?
So that's a very valid point. So we look at that as well, and we look at how to constantly optimize the app. So from that point of view, we are basically tweaking the app to make it as small as possible. So one, it doesn't take up a lot of space on the device of the customer. And secondly, we optimize the in-app experience so that loading times are fast, so there's no lagging behind.
And you've seen tremendous growth in this business. And of course, we know that e-commerce allows companies to collect so much more information about their customers. In what ways are things like machine learning and other technologies helping Zalora better target products to their audiences here?
We see ourselves as being a data-driven business, a data-first business, if you want to look at it that way. So really understanding our audiences and making sure that we use the data properly. Just to give you an example, like you mentioned, we might be using some machine learning in our advertising, and we might be having attribution, for example, that tells us, oh, your paid search is doing really well. You should narrow down on this channel rather than investing on another channel. That's great, but I think we're trying to get to the next level of that, where we look at paid search, but then we go even more granular than that. We would look at paid search, this specific creative targeting this specific demographic is doing fantastically well. Let's hedge our bets on that one. So it's kind of that level of granularity that we're looking at in terms of when we're planning our communications and where we're planning our marketing.
In a way, it seems your customers know Zalora really well. It's a brand they know. At the same time, they haven't had the experience of going into a physical store. So what are the challenges for a purely e-commerce play to create that kind of social media presence or marketing presence to be sort of seen as human or create that authenticity that consumers kind of want from their brands?
Yeah, so I think if you ask me, golden rule of social media is engagement and storytelling. So it's kind of giving customers stories that they can relate to, be it that you're a brand or that you're a person. You know, you at the end of the day, it's all about the storytelling. So some examples could be like giving customers access to backstage product launches or fashion shows. I think they really want to understand what's happening behind the scenes, you know, kind of giving them exclusive access to these things.
So how does that work in the case of Zalora? Do you feel like you can replace you know, traditional brick and mortar stores, or will there always be customers who want to shop for fashion both online and offline?
I think customers are going to shop for fashion anywhere and everywhere. That's how I see it. So customers are not going to just shop offline or online exclusively. I think it's one of those things where you're constantly on the go, meeting people, doing things, and then you might be purchasing from an offline store, you might be going online later in the evening and finishing a purchase after you visited the store. So I think the role of the store maybe is slightly evolving. It's just maybe rethinking what is the purpose of the store. Is it becoming more of an engagement channel? Is it becoming more of a place, again, where you tell your stories? So if I think of a really interesting example is the Burberry store in London, where they were able to create really immersive experiences. So I feel like a lot of the stores that are opening these days, or a lot of the brands that are trying to do new things, they're repurposing the store slightly just to be able to engage the customers a bit more.
When you look ahead to the next 5 or 10 years, what are the sort of advances that you hope to see either in AI or in general tech innovation that will keep disrupting and changing the e-commerce market for fashion?
I think there's quite a few things here. I think one of them is visual search. On the Zalora app itself, you're able to search now visually, and the conversion rate is much higher than a normal text search or voice search. Then I'm thinking augmented reality here. So we're looking at a lot of tools that allow you to try on outfits, you know, kind of visualize yourself wearing a pair of sunglasses, trying on different types of makeup. And then if I was to think about what's happening now and what I think we're going to see more of as well, with third point would be video platforms. So we've seen the emergence of TikTok in recent years across the world. So it, you know, kind of emerged from China. They did a massive acquisition with Musical.ly, and now they're, you know, they're really becoming a powerhouse. I think they're here to stay, and just shows again the power of visual storytelling and the power of being able to kind of engage with your audience. So I think that's sort of technology where, you know, you kind of can bring video to the forefront. I think that's going to be here to stay.
So you've worked in London, you've worked in Southeast Asia. What's different about the consumers in this part of the world compared to other places that you've worked?
I think here we're seeing emerging consumer in some of our markets. So if we think about Philippines and Indonesia, for example, the population size is huge over there. And now we're seeing this consumer that has, you know, quite a considerable spending power compared to previous years. So they, you know, they do want access to high quality products as well. So we're seeing a growth in demand in these regions. So this is very, very exciting time to be in these markets, because, you know, you're part of the growth and you're able to basically connect these customers to the limitless world of fashion. So it's super exciting to be part of that and see how the consumers here are kind of transitioning, you know, and having this disposable income and access to not just fashion e-commerce, but also travel, you know, entertainment and so on.
That's great. Exciting note to end on. I think we'll stop there. Thanks very much,
Thank
Alan.
You so much.
My pleasure. And thank you for joining us here for Coffee and Conversation on DTCN. I'm your host, Shashank Bengali, and we'll see you next time.
Thank you.